us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord.
No, mine's not, but yours probably is. Earnestly seeking
will move all the doubt.
Earnestly.
And cause us to see.
You heard us in song, they weren't there.
Mine was. Where have you been?
Do you honestly seek Him? God. Do you pray?
Yes, sir. Right. Yes, sir.
Do you honestly seek Him when you wake up in the morning?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Do you honestly study His Word?
Yes, my Lord.
Do you earnestly come to the household of the Lord? Are you earnestly seeking Him?
Mm.
Because those are the ones that He rewards.
Right.
Is that somebody here need a reward tonight?
All right.
That's the key to earnestly seek Him.
Hmm.
Because that's the evidence of true faith. I'm going to say this and then we're going to end in prayer. But Bethlehem is a good place to earnestly seek God.
Mm-hmm.
Or any church open in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the Word of God going forth.
Mm-hmm.
Some people who come marginally and you really, really can't grow in the faith by coming marginally.
Sure.
That's like saying that within a week's time I eat maybe on once or twice within a week.
Right. Yeah.
You know, if you did that with your physical body, you'd starve to death. And we try to do that with the things of God. Oh, we'll show up every once in a while on Wednesday night. Every once in a while on Sundays. And then there's some who show up here and they're too busy noticing other folk and what they're saying and what they're doing. And they're here, but they're not earnestly seeking God.
Yeah, right. Yeah, all right.
You can make it through those doors and earnestly see what other folk are saying and doing. And some folk will say, you know, I don't want to go to that church because, you know, those people are hypocrites. And I like to say, well, we all hypocrites.
Amen.
We all hypocrites.
All
right. We all say something and do something different.
All right.
Amen. Church is a hospital.
Right.
And it's a place where a sick folk come to be healed.
Yeah.
And if God said that He had a blessing up in here for me, I'm not going to let anybody stop me from my blessing.
That's it.
See, Christianity is not weak. The devil has people just set up for you to put on a show when you get here, to turn you around.
Yeah.
To make you mad, to get you to leave.
Yeah. Sure.
But we as Christians, we have to feed hope and we have to get tough.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody's going to stop me from my blessing.
Amen.
Amen. No, nobody.
Mm-hmm.
God say that I have a blessing and you in the way,
you better move around.
Guess what? We're going to have some issues. We're going to have some issues. Because I'm going to get my blessing.
Because
I'm earnestly seeking Him.
Amen.
I'm not going to allow anybody to stop me coming for what a blessing is.
Amen.
Hello?
Mm-hmm.
Somebody has to get tough if you want to be rewarded. Earnestly seek Him. You have to be earnest because it's not going to be easy.
All right.
You know, it's not easy to pray when you get up in the morning. Every time, flood your mind, but prayer. Mm. Your to-do list and everything you got to do. Some of us need to learn that, okay, but maybe we need to wake up an hour early.
That's it.
Amen.
If you really want to earnestly seek him. You know, those who have kids, maybe I can't pray in the house. Maybe I have to go on a prayer walk. I've got to earnestly seek him. That's what Jesus did. Jesus lived in a community where, you know, houses were small. There was a reason why he had to go to the garden. He had to get away to pray, earnestly seek him. You get away to pray. Do you shut off the TV? Do you shut off your children's? I mean, my mother, when she prayed, I knew not to mess with her when she prayed. Because she was earnestly seeking him, we would have issues. If I said, Mama! Mama! Pat! Better wait till she get through. Because she was earnestly seeking him. Oh, we got to learn to set up some walls. No, I turn off the cell phone. Have you ever noticed any of you try to earnestly seek him and it's prayer time, you get the call? Everybody want to talk to you then. You got to take the phone and turn off the cell phone. Turn off the TV. Set yourself in a room or go to a garden.
All right.
But you've got to earnestly seek him.
Amen.
Because he will reward you. But the other way you'll do that is that you have faith. You believe that he is. I believe that he is. I believe that he exists. Do you believe that he exists?
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Do you believe that he exists?
Amen.
Let me do a little test. I just happen to have some money that normally don't happen. The wife gave me a little money. I usually ended up giving it away. She's looking at me now. But if you believe that's money, come and get it. My money! My
money! I got my twin.
That's how we need to.
See, I'm
gonna keep rocking. Boy, y'all quick, boy.
Do that again. Do that again. I missed it.
But that's how we have to be about God.
All right. That's it.
Johnny on the spot.
Yeah, Johnny on the spot. Didn't take much thinking.
Well, you didn't even think about it.
But he rewards those who earnestly seek him. There are rewards in this thing.
That's it.
Free blessings.
Rewards.
Go get it. Go get it.
Don't you know those who will invest? One of the reasons I invest in missions because I know it's going to be a reward. Mm-hmm. Brian, don't be ashamed to ask. You better learn. You're going to be a minister. We're going to get you over that. But the best way to ask this is for missions. If they're willing to go halfway around the world, the least I can do is give a little something.
All right.
And my little something may be the key to revival breaking out halfway around the world.
Yes.
Ooh, that's deep in it. So how much is enough? Jesus is enough.
That's it. That's it.
How much do I need to extract all that I have, every little bit that I have? How much is he going to have left over for me? Extra, everything that I need. Oh, but I have to have faith enough to believe that he is God and that he exists.
But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.